Mike Corliss from Tormach. Today we're going to mount a 3-jaw chuck in the new Tormach slant bed lathe. Okay, when you go to mount your chuck, take it out of the box. The studs are going to be loose. Okay, you got to install the studs. Studs have a little gauge line on them. You got to screw them in so they're flush with the back of the chuck. They just thread right into these holes. It's too deep, I'll go right there. And then there's a groove in the side of them that has to line up right with this counter bore. A socket head cap screw goes in there, and then it keeps those retention studs from backing out. Tension studs screwed in. Now when you first get your lathe, there's no markings on the spindle nose. I like to mark, I'll put a witness mark on it, just so I put the chuck in and out the same, so it's orientated the same way each time. I'm just going to put a mark on it with a black marker. You can take a Dremel and etch a line into it, use a paint pen, a stamp set, whatever you want. But just put a witness mark on there. And then after, like I'll put a witness mark on the chuck after I get it in there so it lines up with the witness mark I put on here. And then every time I put the chuck in, I'll put it in the same way. For the hard jaws, it's not going to matter, but these are movable jaws. If you make any soft jaws, you're going to want to make sure you have the chuck orientated the same way each time. That way you're going to get better repeatability for your run-up. Okay. So now we put this in. Okay, it slides in like this. You turn the cam locks. You just snug them up, and then you can go back and tighten them further after you got them snugged up. There's a line on these cam locks. When it's rotated up vertically to say 12 o'clock, that's the off position. Then you want them to lock solid between say like 3 and 6 o'clock. If your cam lock swings past 6 o'clock with that witness mark, it's gone too far. And you have to take the chuck off and then just thread it in one more thread for those retention studs. If it doesn't go down to past 3 o'clock, take it off and then loosen it one thread. Because you want that witness mark to be, like I said, between 3 o'clock and six o'clock. It's hard to see, but the mark is right there on the cam lock itself. I'll rotate it up to the free position. That's where it's got to be to remove the chuck. It's got to be lined up at 12.
Okay.
And then you rotate it around, and this is locking it in. And you want that mark to be between 3 and 6 o'clock. So right there is where you want it to lock up tight.
Okay.
So you check all the witness marks. This one's about 4 o'clock. And that one's about the same. So all those studs tightened down to that gauge line are pretty good on this chuck. But if you get one that's off a little bit, you can just adjust to the thread. Okay. And now that I got the chuck in there with the mark that I put on the spindle face, I can just put another mark up on the chuck itself just so they line up. Now when I put the chuck on and off, all I got to do is line up those witness marks, and then any soft jaws I made should repeat pretty well. Okay, so after you have all the lugs, so they're at 3 o'clock, after you've done some cutting, it's going to lock up on that taper, on that face. Just give it a wrap with a soft hammer. And then that's going to loosen it up, okay? It's not going to fall off because you still got the lugs engaged, but it's going to be loose. And then you can go ahead and turn these all up to the 12 o'clock position and then remove the chuck. Okay, so you got your chuck mounted. You got the witness marks on it, either stamped on or dremeled in. Now, if you want to put a set of soft jaws on it, you just take the hard jaws off, and then if you just make up your own aluminum jaws or purchase some, just take the screws out. And as you remove them, if you look on the inside of the jaw, there's going to be a number right here. You see that?
Yeah.
Okay. This one's got the 3. You might want to take a marker and put a 3 on the outside of this, or take a Dremel and etch it right into your master jaw. So these go back on the same way that you take them off. And then when you put soft jaws on, just number them or also so they correspond. Then if you ever switch soft jaws or put your hard jaws back in, everything's going to repeat real well for you. Okay, that's all there is to mounting a 3-jaw chuck. If you get a 4-jaw chuck, just go through the same steps. It's going to be the same thing, or one extra jaw, but the actual installation and removal of the chuck is the same thing.